Here, we shall discuss about the Gauss law. The statement of the Gauss law is the electric flux passing through any closed surface is equal to the charge enclosed by that closed surface. This is the statement. That is, flux passing through any closed surface is equal to the charge enclosed by that closed surface. Now, here consider this one, it is a closed surface and a charge Q, it is present within that closed surface. Consider a charge Q enclosed by a closed surface of surface area S. Here, this one it is a closed surface. The surface area of that closed surface is S. And also consider differential surface area. Differential surface area on the surface of that closed surface. Within the surface, consider a differential surface element of area ds. Here, instead of considering the total closed surface, only consider some incremental area or a differential surface area. Incremental area or a differential surface area on the surface of the closed surface Here, the electric flux density is normal to ds. Electric flux density, it is normal to the differential surface element which is considered on the surface of the closed surface. And En, it is a unit vector which makes an angle theta with the flux density at the ds. Here, it is the direction of the flux density. And here it is a unit vector in that directions, and this unit vector, it makes an angle theta with the direction of the electric flux density. Now the differential flux deep ds passing through that differential surface element ds, differential flux, electric flux passing through this differential surface element. Because first you have considered a total surface and a charge is enclosed within that surface, and when that charge is enclosed, here this charge, the electric flux lines, it is uniformly passes through the surface, closed surface. On that closed surface, here some differential surface element is considered. Now, differential flux or the incremental flux which is passing through this incremental surface area, that is ds, is equal to dn ds. Dn, it indicates it is the normal component of the electric flux density. Now, the normal component of the electric flux density, it can be written as d is equal to cos theta. That is normal component of the flux density. Now, the incremental flux, it can be written as d cos theta ds. But the dot product of two vectors is equal to a modulus b cos theta. So that, due to which the incremental flux which is passing through this incremental surface or a differential surface is d, is equal to modulus of d, modulus of ds cos theta. From that, you shall write here that the according to the property of the dot product, the incremental flux passing through that incremental surface, it can be written as d dot ds. Here, this d psi, it is the incremental flux passing or a differential flux passing through a differential surface area. That is only small incremental surface which is ds is a small incremental surface which is considered on the surface of the enclosed surface which encloses a charge q. Now then total flux passing through the entire closed surface, then the total flux passing through the entire closed surface, that can be obtained by taking the integrals. By taking, since here it is a closed surface, that's why here the total flux can be obtained by taking the closed integration of the d psi is equal to psi is equal to closed integral, that is d dot ds. It gives the total electric flux passing through that entire closed surface. Closed integral d dot ds. Psi is equal to closed integral d dot ds, then this is the total flux which is passing through entire closed surface. Here, compare these two equations, this one and this one. Here, I have taken the closed surface. A integration with this mark, a integration with this marks, it indicates it is a closed surface. Total integration within of a closed surface, that's why you have used this one from the comparison of these two. Here it is only for the differential surface element, but this is for the entire closed surface. Okay. Now, the proof of the Gauss law. Here, first of all, you have considered a sphere of radius r with its center at the origin. Here, this one, it is a sphere. Of radius r with its center at the origin and a charge q is also placed at the origin. Consider a sphere of radius r with the center at the origin and a charge q is placed at the origins. Here center of the sphere is also origin and a charge q is also, it is placed at the center of the origins. So that from this one, the sphere, it encloses a charge q. The electric flux passing uniformly through the surface of the sphere. Electric flux passing uniformly through the surface of the sphere, so that flux density d is directed radially outwards from the surface of the sphere. Electric flux density d is directed radially outwards from the surface of the sphere. Here, the flux density at any point on the surface of the sphere due to charge q at the center of the sphere is d is equal to q upon 4 pi r square a r. Here, it is a unit vector directed radially from the sphere, and r it is the radius of the sphere, q it is a charge which is placed at the center of the spheres, so that the flux density, electric flux density at any point on the surface of the sphere due to a charge q at the center of the sphere of radius r is d is equal to q upon 4 pi r square a r. Consider a differential surface element on the surface of the sphere or a incremental surface or a differential surface on the surface of the sphere ds is in the radial directions. Because differential surface is also equal to the differential surface is equal to d, it is also a vector quantity, so that ds is equal to r square sin theta d theta r, because this differential surface, incremental surface, it is in the radial directions. Differential surface or a incremental surface, it is in the radial directions, so that this ds is equal to r square sin theta d pi r. So that the electric flux passing through that sphere is equal to closed integral d dot ds and closed integral q upon 4 pi r square r dot r square sin theta d pi r, q upon 4 pi sin theta d pi r dot r. Now this differential surface is equal to r square sin theta d pi r. Here the differential surface in the radial directions, the differential surface area, if it is in the pi directions it will be different, if it is in the theta directions it will be different. So that here you have written r square sin theta d pi r. From that the total flux passing through that surface is theta is equal to 0 to pi, these are the limits for theta, and pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Now q upon 4 pi sin theta d pi r dot r, q upon 4 pi theta is equal to 0 to pi, 0 to sin theta d pi. Now the electric flux passing through that closed surface is equal to q upon 4 pi, that of the integration of sin theta is minus cos theta, and here it is pi, so that q upon 4 pi minus bracket of minus cos pi cos 0 2 pi, so that say electric flux passing through the closed surface it is equal to the charge enclosed. Because according to the definition of that the theorem, the electric flux passing through a closed surface is equal to the charge enclosed. Now one of the significant quantity in the electrostatics, it is the divergence. If Gauss law is applied to a volume element or a cube which is placed with its center at the origin in the Cartesian coordinate systems, then the charge enclosed by that volume element, it is can be written as dou dx upon dou x, dou dy upon dou y, plus dou dz upon dou z.